Alright, so in this part of the tutorial, we're going to reinforce one of the techniques that we just used with nanomesh, but this time we're going to use that to create these sort of like falling rocks and thick pieces, you know, falling from the mouth of the worm. These are just like rocks that I created, or tiny particles that I added in ZBrush as well for my concept. So I'm going to do that, and I'm going to show you a couple of really cool things that you can do to do that. Alright, so we have our, you know, our main scene. I'm going to do a quick save as well. And to create the rock, let's go ahead and select another tool. We're going to use a sphere like so. Click on Make Polymesh 3D. And I'm going to hold the Control and Shift click to select my knife curve. And that allows me to sort of like hold Control and Shift, click and drag to sort of like cut this in this fashion. So I'm just going to do some cuts randomly. You can go ahead and do the same thing. In my case, the size of the rocks for the concept are so tiny that I'm not going to spend too much time on this. I just wanted to show you the full workflow so that you can replicate it. So if you want to do something a bit more, you know, thoroughly done than this, you can totally do so. But this is basically what I did. All right, so now I'm going to go to the geometry palette, click on Dynamesh. So let's Dynamesh this object, control click and drag, and turn off the polyframe. So that's pretty good. I'm going to use the gizmo to give it a bit of shape, so it's not like a rounded shape. There we go. We can also use the trim dynamic, so B, T, and D. So that's the shortcut for trim dynamic. And this is just a cool brush that allows you to trim this very quickly and make it look a bit more organic. But obviously, you can make it as, you know, stylized as you want it to. So I, like I said, I didn't spend too much time on doing this, but I want to show you the entire workflow. All right, so that is my rock. And let's go ahead and hold Control, click and drag to redynamesh. And if you want to sort of polish this even more, you can use the clay polish. So I'm going to open up clay polish, click once, click twice, click and drag to remove the mask that creates, or that is created when you use the clay polish. And that's pretty much it. So this is your rock. Obviously, this is a little bit too heavy in terms of points to use as a particle, especially if you're going to use a bunch of them in your scene. You know, right now is 37,000. So if you multiply this by, I don't know, 100 of these, is going to be quite heavy. So what I like to do is simplify it quite a bit. So let's go ahead and leave it there. Go to C plugin, decimation master, and I'm going to click on pre-process current. So that basically analyzes the geometry. And now we can go to the C plugin palette again, decimation master, and we can set a percentage that we want to decimate or reduce the topology or the amount of points. So I'm going to set it to 5, decimate current. And there we go. We have something a bit simpler. I think I can go even lower than that. Let's set it to 1% from that original 37,000. There we go. So 1% is 370. There we go. All right. So that is exactly what I want to get. Like I said, you can change this and create something as intricate as you want. But in this case, this is all I need. And now let's go ahead and repeat the same process we did for the teeth in terms of creating a brush. So I'm going to click on brush. I want to click on new insert brush, new brush. So now that we have the IMM brush, let's go ahead and turn that into a nanomesh brush. Perfect. So the next thing we're going to do is go back to our working file where we have the worm, and we're going to add or append from the subtool palette a sphere. So I'm going to click on append. It could be anything, actually. I'm just going to click on sphere for now. Select that sphere, go into solo mode, bring in the gizmo. And in the gizmo 3D, you have other options. So you can turn any of the, that's what I said, that it doesn't really matter what you append because you can turn it into anything. And I'm interested in a polysphere. So if I click on polysphere, we have this, and you see we have like a cleaner, it's kind of like a cube turned into a sphere. So we don't have that triangulation. So if I undo that, you see the normal sphere has this triangulation here. And that's not what I want. I want to maintain a uniform set of, or a uniform size for all the polygons. So in that case, this is what I need. All right, let's go ahead and click on Gizmo 3D now. And I'm just going to scale this down. Again, go into solo mode. And this is going to be the base for my rocks. So now all I have to do is press the spacebar. Again, just like I did with the teeth, make sure that I have polygroup all. Click and drag. So now we have those everywhere. Let's go to the nanomesh palette just to, again, reiterate the same sort of process I showed you before with the teeth. I'm going to turn off the placement, and I'm going to use the random distribution to add some of them. And I think the important one with this is to increase the variation in the rotation. So I'm going to push this quite a bit and increase the rotation or the variation as slightest, almost to, you know, 100%. I'm also going to change the width slightly, the length, and the height, and I'm going to variate all of that as well quite a bit. And I'm going to play with the size of the overall size. So now we have a bunch of different rocks very quickly. And again, this is a simple nanomesh, so I can just bring in my gizmo, for example, and move the entire sphere that has all of that. So I'm going to leave this as it is. I already have my, let's say, my cluster of rocks, but I'm not going to decide where to put them until I get to the posing. So let's leave this one as it is, and let's move on to the next part of the tutorial where I'm going to show you how to create the dunes of the desert.